These are three types of variable radius wheels designed to transport a vehicle over a rocky. New concepts are being created almost daily. Some will never get beyond the drawing board, but others, or their descendants, will become part of man's greatest adventure, the exploration and colonization of space.
You ain't no. who lives for excitement. Give him
Huey Newton.
For excitement, give him 007. There's a 007 gift set for every assignment. This one packs the full line, including 007 aftershave, hair dressing, and cologne. That's 007 for the license to kill women.
If you're out there, welcome back to the show. Excuse me. that. Still a bit green at this, and sometimes I don't even know whether you guys are out there. Two reasons for that. And by the way, I'm giving my fingers a little break here. If you saw the earlier thing, we'll get back to that kind of stuff in a bit. But so, the machine I'm running this on is, enough for broadcasting, but just about that. So a couple browser windows and stuff, and that's about all. Also, it still makes me a little bit nervous knowing you guys are out there sometimes, so sometimes I just pretend it's for myself. Might not have mentioned this before. Of course, you're on a Master Monkey experience here. This is my regular production process, actually. I don't go editing beats in a DAW or anything like that. What I like to do is just hit record on my multi-track and then perform stuff live. If I don't get it right, I hit delete and I do it again. It was good enough for the Beatles, it was good enough for Elvis, it's good enough for me. And so that's what I usually do. This stream is simply a webcam plus one of the two channels off of my multi-track. We'll do a quick gear review if that piqued your curiosity there. I say one of two channels because in the lo-fi field, everything's pretty much mono, and that's also the case in most live performances anyways, in case you didn't know. Again, we're taking a quick break here, giving the fingers a bit of a break, and we're going to play with this little loop you're hearing that I've been playing with for a few days. And I'm getting used to talking and stuff. Maybe too used to that. Looks like I dropped the voice changer. Let me know what you guys think of that in the chat, or send me a message. I'll read your messages if you send them on Twitch. Also, you can find me on YouTube, SoundCloud, Twitter, pretty much everywhere. I'm going to turn this down before we get sick of it. Right, quick rear review. I haven't done that on this, so if you're a repeat visitor, you'll like this. If you're new, you'll wonder, hey, does this guy just talk about gear? No, actually, most of the time I'm completely silent and just bang on pads and make weird noises. In the day, it's beats. At night, it's drones, so please subscribe here. Subscribe here. Oh, there is someone there. Hey, Lazy Sloth. Hey, good to see you. Lazy Sloth is, I think, a return, repeat, offender, defender, something like that. So, quick gear review. Yes, I have an actual Casio SK-1 up here that I really use. It's not just for show. I actually use it as part of the show often. Not too much tonight. Tonight's been very drum heavy. Excuse me a moment. I'm on a real drum kick right now, so anyways, SK-1. No, I'm not the original owner. I'm not quite that old. Probably thrift store buy or something. I have two, maybe three of them in great condition, unbent. I use it as shipped from the factory. You wouldn't believe the kinds of capabilities it has. Moving on, we'll get back to that in the show. I'm sure you'll see it. Over here we got a Microbrute. Haven't had very long, exactly as long as the 404. I got them at the same time, actually about a month ago, almost 2 months ago now. Excuse me. Both of these 2 months, I've owned other synths before, so, but as a learner synth, if you're curious, I highly recommend the Brute. It's a great little piece of gear. It's a monster. It can be a little bit squirrely, so I apologize sometimes if once in a while we get a crazy noise out of it, but I try to keep that under control. The 404 is my main focus right now. I've been using a 202 for a long time, so I'm getting accustomed to the 404 still. You might note that I mostly treat it like a 202 with just four more pads. That's mostly what I do right now, except in more polyphony. We'll get back to that. Again, had both of them about 2 months. If you wondered, yes, the numbers are missing because I've beaten them all off. If you watch the show a little bit, you'll see why and how that happens. Finally over here, we got the 202. It's a, SP-202. It's a lo-fi classic. It's a standard if you do lo-fi. This is a big thing. I've been messing with this thing for like 10 years in my own personal time just for the hell of it. I've got just piles of tapes and mini discs. Yes, mini discs. I didn't realize it was like a whole thing, but so anyways, I guess I'm lo-fi. I didn't realize I was lo-fi, but I am. I just love the sound of it, and you'll hear plenty of it. Oh, we're listening to it right now. It doesn't have the same kind of polyphony, so you can't use it quite in the same way, but there are many tricks that we take advantage of. Shit, I think that's enough talking. Anybody got questions? Anyone out there? Come in the chat. I'm pointing to it. It's a bit of a trick to do so. Okay, come into the chat and with Lazy Sloth. And be nice to Lazy Sloth, or we'll slap you around or something. Here's an idea. Request, if you have a request, send me the, a song or something. We'll sample some bits of it and beat the crap out of it. We won't replicate it because that's boring. We're going to play with this loop a bit now that I've been messing around with the last few days. Here we go. Excuse me a moment, there, viewers. I can barely hear myself. Hold on a second. Thank you. Wow, that is really sweet.
Thank you. sound.
Thank you.
At that time. At that time.
Of this establishment wishes me to inform you that if you are dissatisfied with your purchase, please feel free to seek a full refund from the management for your full purchase price.
Hello, welcome to Dive Master.
Thank you.
Give him double.
If you're still out there, thank you very much for coming to the show. Usually by now, I'm pretty tapped out, literally, if you get the pun, because of the way I do that. Anyways, usually we play with more of these. I'm not sure. If you were here earlier, you might have caught some of the Microbrute. I'm serious. We pull all of this out at one time or another. Usually by now, I'd call it quits. But you know what? I'm actually going to try to take a kind of extended break, 10, maybe 15 minutes. People have been telling me to try and stretch the thing out. You know, I have a treat for you, though. Here, I have this little track. No one's heard, not track, just something. Anyways, I'm going to shut up now. We'll be back in 10. Thanks a lot, everybody. Really, seriously, I really appreciate it. And subscribe here. Hey, there's Rank Pop. He's awesome. Thank you, Rank Pop. Massive shout out. If you're not already subscribed, you should subscribe to Rank Pop. He's got this really cool thing he's doing with his people. I hope you guys can hear me. Anyways, I was saying you should subscribe to Rank Pop because he's got this cool thing he's doing. So check it out. I'm back in 10. Thank you, everybody. I'm back in 10.
You ain't help.
There's a 007 gift set for every assignment. This one packs the full line, including 007 aftershave, hair dressing, and cologne. That's 007 for the license to kill women. Including 007 aftershave, hairdressing, and cologne. That's 007 for the license to kill women.
That. Yes, that was a yes, someone give Lazy his refund. What the hell was that? That was there's a commercial from the 60s for a cologne for 007, and that was the song for it. Anyways, I let it play for a few seconds and then hit reverse, and then it was the end of the commercial. Actually, the beginning of the next commercial was a woman talking, so that was the... By the way, could somebody out there tell me what mod is and why people want it, and if they want it, then I'll give it to them. And somebody give Lazy Sloth a refund for his $0. And again, vote in the chat. Do you want to make beats, or what do you think we should do? Let's just... I'm going to drum... Oh, yeah, so what I was doing earlier... I just set the Microbrute to nothing. I triggered this on with this. This is an old keyboard trick, the oldest maybe. And then I'm setting the... There's an echo here. All right, now I can't hear myself. That's all right. So, yeah, then I'm setting the LFO. The LFO goes really crazy fast. I'm not sure if you can probably hear that now. Sorry about that. The LFO goes crazy fast, also can go slow. So I'm just using the LFO on a... What am I using here? On a square waveform as a sort of rhythm, so I can use that as a backing to kind of practice drumming, basically. Let's do that for a while.
Feeling better, team? Feeling
better, Mike. I swear. I didn't imagine that.
Wes.
I think we'll make it. The beginning again.
Walking up and down and turning down song, you crazy?
You guys don't mind, I'm going to stop the sound there for a second to look at the chat here. I see. A maid? Wait, why would someone want to be a maid, though? So suppose there may be some esteem associated with it, that sort of thing. Well, if someone wants to help out in the channel, they're that big of a supporter of Freaky Noise, that would be cool. Once in a while, I had people come in here and say stuff. Not that I notice, because I'm just banging away. Anyways, that was weird. What happened here is I've got this compressor effect on the 404 because the drums were too quiet, and just in a flippant moment, I flipped the compressor on. Now, when the synth is on, it's fine, but then if another sound pushes in from the sampler, pushes the synth out, it's actually kind of cool. I think we might mess with that for a while, but in case you were wondering what that was. We'll be right back. That was cool, huh? That was fun. I think I think I'm gonna use that and add that to my playbook. The compressor on the 404. That's with the compressor, guys. That's without the compressor here. Whoa, it's actually louder. All right, well, we'll get back to that. Anyways, with the compressor on. That's because I turned it down. It was too loud. Anyways, with the compressor on. When the 404 is running, or when the synth input signal is running through the 404, like that, and another sound comes in from the 404, it cuts off the external sound, which is the synth in this case, so we get this. That's pretty cool, actually. So add that to your little 404 playbook. By the way, in case you thought that was like signal overdriving, that's not what that was. I thought it was too. So back to this. Sure, if you guys hear that mic up a little bit and sound down, I might have to put headphones on. If you guys get feedback, let me know. All right, Lazy Sloth. Hey, that'd be cool, dude. And in return, I'll give you a full refund. A Lazy Sloth says, explains to me, a noob broadcaster still, what a mod is. And I just thought it was a stylish youth movement from the early 60s. Just kidding. And offered to do that, so I think I will do that. Thank you very much. Then you can give yourself a refund. So subscribe here. I'm almost tapped out, I think, maybe, but I want to play with this Radio Shack sample I got. There it is. It came from that same set of old 60s commercials that I found. And by the way, I'm not this old. I'm just digging, you know, and looking for new sources. So that's what we're always looking for, stuff that people hasn't already been tapped all to hell, right? So, I mean, you don't sample James Brown. Even if you did and it was awesome, I mean, of course it's going to be awesome. It's freaking James Brown, right? So, but if you make something awesome out of a Radio Shack sample, then you are awesome. That's how it works here at the Monkey Channel. Again, thanks for tuning in. It means a lot to me, you guys. And subscribe here and tell your friends. Or if you don't like it, tell your enemies. And that works too. Back to the noise.
Radios, stereos, recorders, everything in sound. Radios, stereos, recorders. 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 Every. Radios, stereos, recorders. Every. Radios, stereos, recorders. Everything in sound. Well, that's it. I am definitely, truly now tapped out. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. I sure hope you caught some of that hip-hop. Oh, it's hip-hop hobby club. Sorry, I can barely read the text on my screen there. Still getting used to all this crap. Really, man, appreciate you guys sticking in with me for these awkward early stages. And thank you, Lazy Sloth, and this guy's going to be the mod, you guys. So Lazy Sloth, yay, first mod, and first person to receive a refund, and first mod to give a refund. So again, I really appreciate everything, you guys. I hope I'm not talking too much. I hope somebody tells me to shut up someday, because actually I prefer to just make the noise, but I do really appreciate you guys, and you deserve some communication. So I'm going to leave you with this little sample I'm going to play with a little bit while I shut things down here. And please do subscribe and check out the schedule. I'm always on anyways, doing some sort of weird stuff. I love you.